Our last scene is set in the great castle hall. Arline is attending her coming out ball. When Thaddeus with Devilshoof appears all forgiving, he pleads she'll come back to their Romany living. For a life with our hero doth she fondly confess why she has as a keepsake her old gypsy dress. The guests for the party are now heard arriving. The men must quick vanish, no time for conniving.
Thank you.
Out of the casement goes Devilhoof's rump, and into the wardrobe does Thaddeus jump. Florestein enters and suspects something shady. His suspicions are proved by our triangle's lady. 'Tis the queen of the gypsies, and she doth describe how Arline's betrothed to a man from her tribe. The count won't believe till she opens the closet. It looks as if Thaddeus will lose his deposit. The queen is prepared to take Thaddeus away, but Arline will counter this game, set, match, play. Alone with her father, she pleads with agility, and Thaddeus reveals he's from Polish nobility. The pleas of our lovers soon move the count's heart. He pardons our hero. The pair need not part. But the drama's not over. The queen's not been sleeping. From the window, a furious flintlock is peeping. The queen aims her gun at the heroine's head, but Devilshoof spots her. With horror and dread, he leaps to her side and shoves round the muzzle. 'Tis the queen who falls dead, thus resolving our puzzle. The lovers unite, and it's end to all strife. They sing of the joys of the gay gypsy life. In marble halls for Arline, things couldn't be dreamier. And thus ends our tale of the girl from Bohemia.
Which they on me can pour, which they You've been listening to a concert performance by the Glasnevin Musical Society of Michael Balfe's three-act opera, The Bohemian Girl, recorded in the National Concert Hall. The cast, in order of singing, was Count Arnhem, Niall Murray, Thaddeus, a Polish exile, Jeff Cresswell, Devilshoof, leader of the Gypsies, Peter McBrien, Florestein, the Count's nephew, Frank Dunne, Queen of the Gypsies, Ruth Maher, Arline, the Count's daughter, abducted in infancy by the Gypsies, Virginia Kerr, with the Glasnevin Musical Society Chorus, Chorus Master Reggie Lawless, and the RTE Concert Orchestra leader Martin Loveday, conducted by Colman Pearse. Ian Fox was the narrator, and production for radio was by John Carolan. At 25 to 9 next Sunday night, we'll be broadcasting a recording of the Glasnevin Musical Society's concert performance of Benedict's The Lily of Killarney, with Virginia Kerr, Nicholas Sharkey, Anna Caleb, Louis Brown, Frank Dunne and Peter McBrien, and the RTE Concert Orchestra, conducted by Colman Pearse. That's a concert performance of The Lily of Killarney next Sunday night at 25 minutes to 9. And on Sunday, the 25th of July, at the same time, we'll broadcast a concert performance of William Vincent Wallace's opera, Maritana. Well, it's 17 minutes to 11. We've got new summary at 11 o'clock. But until then, some music. Morceau de Matin by Elgar, played by the Royal Philharmonic Orchestra, conducted by Lawrence Collingwood. From Sylvia by Delibes, played by the Boston Symphony Orchestra, conducted by Pierre Montieu. Clair de Lune by Debussy, played by the Morton Gould Orchestra. It's 3 minutes to 11, taking us up to the new summary at 11 o'clock. We have part of the Allegro from the Concerto for Two Violins and String Orchestra in D minor by Bach. Festival strings of